Good morning, children. In last biology class, we moved to the next chapter, components of food. We discussed about the various nutrients to be present in our daily food so that we would get a balanced diet and be healthy. We saw carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fat, and water are the nutrients which are required for the human body. We discussed the carbohydrates, fat and proteins. Yes, the first three we discussed it in the last class. We saw the food materials riches in them and the three tests we discussed. Test for carbohydrate or starch, test for protein and test for fats. These three tests we discussed, and this would help us to find out the nutrient present in a given food material, right? So in today's class, we are going to discuss about the next two nutrients, that is vitamins and minerals. So what is the role of vitamins in human body? They prevent diseases. Okay, we human beings have a normal immunity power to protect ourselves from being affected by diseases, right? So how did the immunity power come into the human body? From the food we eat. In the food, vitamins play the role of preventing diseases. So the vitamins will take care of the eyes, bones, teeth, gum, and for their strong and healthy nature, vitamins are responsible. The vitamins is a broad name given. It has many types in it. Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K, and vitamin B complex. Okay, it is another group of vitamin where you will have subclassifications like vitamin B1, B2, B12 and all that you would be learning in your higher grades in detail. So this is the major vitamins present in the human body: A, C, D, E, K and B complex. So each vitamin has a specific role to perform. Okay, the vitamin A is responsible for the growth of skin and the healthy nature of eyes. You could have seen people wearing spectacles if they are not able to see the objects clearly. This is because they have insufficient amount of vitamin A in their diet. They are deficient of vitamin A. Deficient means which is not in the suitable amount. Okay, which is less than the required. Vitamin C is responsible to fight diseases. And vitamin D takes care of the bones and teeth. You would have learned this in your lower grades itself. Bones are strong enough because we drink milk and the milk has calcium in it, and the calcium is good in vitamin D. Okay, so all these vitamins have a specific role to perform. You have to keep this in your mind. So now let us see, how are we getting these vitamins from the food we eat? What are the food materials which are all rich in the vitamins? Okay, so vitamin D, as you see, it is obtained from the sunlight. We move out during the daytime and the sunlight falls on us. That is also a good source of vitamin D. We can obtain vitamin D through the sunlight also, apart from the food we eat. So this is a table listing out the various food items which are all rich in the vitamins. So vitamin A is present in milk, fish oil, carrot and potato. Vitamin B is present in liver, rice and wheat. Vitamin C, present in orange, tomato, lemon, amla and guava. Okay, so these food items are going to help us to prevent diseases, because vitamin C fights diseases. We saw that before, right? Vitamin D is present in milk, butter, eggs and fish. Now, if you notice in this table, the food items like milk and fish are rich in two or more vitamins, right? Milk is rich in vitamin A, milk is rich in vitamin D2, right? And we have already seen in the last class that rice is a good source of carbohydrates. Potato is also rich in carbohydrates. And here we again see that potato is rich in vitamin A and rice is rich in vitamin B. So, does it mean that the food items are rich in two or more nutrients? Yes. The food items which we eat may contain two or more nutrients in them. Like we see here, rice is rich in carbohydrates as well as it is rich in vitamin B. Potato is rich in carbohydrates as well as it is rich in vitamin A. Okay? Next, let us move to the next nutrient, that is minerals. Minerals and vitamin are different. Okay, my dear children, they are all the various forms of nutrients present in our body. The minerals include iodine, phosphorus, iron, calcium, magnesium. If you take any health drink or any kind of health food items, if you see, for example, you are drinking Horlicks in the morning, right? Along with the milk. So if you turn over the Horlicks box and see, the company would have listed out the various nutrients present in the product. You could see iodine, phosphorus, iron, calcium, magnesium, fat. Okay, so they are all indicating the amount of nutrient present in that special health drink. Clear? So the minerals like iodine, phosphorus are also necessary for the growth of human beings. They are going to provide the proper growth of the body. They are also a very important one. If you look this table, the food items rich in iodine are spinach, ginger, fish. Phosphorus are present in chili, banana, milk, rice and wheat. Iron is rich in apple, guava, liver and spinach. Calcium, as we know already that milk and eggs are good in calcium. So, okay children, now nutrients, we discussed carbohydrates, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals. And the food items which are all rich in this, we discuss until this, right? Next, we have roughages and water. If all these nutrients are present in our food diet, then it is called as a balanced diet. A balanced diet will ensure the proper growth and health of the human beings. Now let us see, what is this roughages and water? Why are they required? Roughages is nothing but the dietary fibers. Okay, they are not present in the food item, or it is not obtained from the plants and animals. We eat grains, pulses and seeds and all, nuts and all we eat. Right? So they have the dietary fibers in them, which is also required for the growth of human body. And water is a very important one. Water will help us to digest the food, and if these roughage and water is not there, we will not have the ability to absorb this nutrients by the human body. The food items will be these nutrients will be present in the food items. If we eat them, it has to be properly digested and it has to be absorbed by the body cells, right? So roughages and water are helping us to digest the food properly. Clear? Now I have a question to you. Does the nutrients present in the food items are completely taken by the human body? I mean, if rice is a carbohydrate food, right? We know that rice is rich in carbohydrates. If we eat rice, are we absorbing the entire amount of carbohydrates present in it through our food which we eat daily? If the answer, my answer would be definitely no. We don't eat the raw rice seeds directly. To cook the rice, we wash it twice or thrice so that the dirts present in the grains are washed away. I'm telling you clearly, my dear children, through the process of washing the grains or vegetables or pulses or fruits, whatever we eat, some of the nutrients are lost in it. By the process of washing these food items, the nutrients are lost. Okay? Few nutrients are lost by washing. And while the process of cooking, some amount of nutrients is lost. And at the end, the food which is cooked, when we eat it, we obtain only a little amount of nutrient from it. Okay? So how do we compensate for the required entire amount of nutrients for the proper growth of the human body? If some amount of nutrients is lost by washing and cooking, how do we compensate? How does our body compensate the remaining? That is with the help of roughages and water. Okay? So we would have seen that we eat orange, apple, all these fruits as raw, and sometimes we eat carrot also as raw vegetable. Okay, so by eating some foods, by eating some vegetables raw and the fruits are taken continuously, means we can compensate for the loss of the nutrients while washing and cooking. Okay. If you see here, vitamin C is present in the food items like orange, tomato, lemon, apple and guava. These food items are rich in vitamin C. But vitamin C has a tendency to lose all the properties when it is cooked. Okay, so when cooking, vitamin C is completely lost. And that is why we eat these food items raw. Okay. So we discussed the next two nutrients, that is vitamins and minerals, and the food items which are all rich in them. And we discussed what should a balanced diet consist of and the necessity of eating vegetables and fruits in raw format also was discussed today. Okay, let us meet in the next class, my dear children. Thank you.